Just whistle while you work.
All right, everybody, welcome to Whistle While You Work podcast. This is episode 21, Shopping at Disney. And we have a special guest.
Special guest to kick us off.
Say your name, special guest.
Henry.
Henry. Okay, Henry, do I know you?
Yes.
I do. How do I know you?
Because I'm your son.
Oh, you're my son. That's right. Well, I have a lot of sons. Which son are you?
The youngest.
The youngest? Oh, that would make you number four son.
Yeah, tell them how old you are.
I'm 8 years old, turning 9 this year.
I know. 9 and like 2 months.
Probably 1.5 hours.
That's exciting. Well, we're excited to have Henry join us. He's so lucky because all of his brothers are gone away to summer camp right now for the next few days. And so he's the only one home.
Yeah. We told him, hey, we're going to do our podcast. And he said, when do I get to be on? And we said, okay, let's figure it out. So, okay, we got your first question. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What is your favorite ride at Hollywood Studios?
That's so hard. Either Tower of Terror or Rock and Roller Coaster. Those are the two hardest ones I've ever had before.
Oh, okay. That's
probably
okay.
Probably Tower of Terror.
Okay, that's all right if you have a tie.
That's a good one.
You do that one with Dad, huh?
Yes. When I was 4, I first did that ride. I'm like, and then my friend Wade first did when he went to Disney World.
All right. Okay.
I'm not even screaming loud.
Tell us, what is your favorite ride at Animal Kingdom? Talk this way.
Either Mount Everest or Mount Everest.
Expedition Everest.
Whatever it is, yes.
Okay. Remember that time we did that 9 times in one trip?
Yes, the line was like 5 minutes long.
Yep. It took us longer to like wind through the line than actually, you know, do the ride.
No, it took us longer to do the ride than wind through the line.
Well, that could be true. All right, Dad, what's your question for him?
Well, so we talked about Hollywood and Animal Kingdom. What's your favorite ride at Magic Kingdom?
That's a decently hard one. Space Mountain or Big Thunder Mountain or Pirates of the Caribbean really hit me off.
Oh, yeah.
It's hard to pick between those three, but honestly, I would say Space Mountain.
Space Mountain. Favorite. I endorse that. I think that's a good one.
I'm sensing a theme of thrills here, aren't you? Except Pirates, that wasn't a thrill. That's just a good old amazing ride.
It's just a great ride. All right, so what about Epcot? Do you have a favorite ride at Epcot?
When Guardians of the Galaxy, they said they're going to have throw-up bags on it, so I assume it's going to be good. So eventually, that's probably going to be my favorite ride there, but so far for right now, probably Test Track.
Test Track, another thrill attraction. That's a good one.
You got a need for speed, huh?
The only thing I like is thrills.
Well,
drops.
You know, they have throw-up bags on Mission Space. Don't you love that one?
Yeah, well, that's because it's, like, spinny and whirling around.
You can't see the glare he just gave. Our listeners can't see the glare he just gave Dad on that question. All right, dude, we got one more question. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
So there's some new things coming out, some new rides. So if you had to pick one that you're most excited about, is it Ratatouille? That's new. That's going to be new to you.
Yes.
Guardians or Tron?
Tron.
Tron.
Like, when you said Tron, all right, that's coming out. I forgot that. I thought that's going to come out in 2030.
It's taking a long time to come out, isn't it?
Yeah, it's such a giant ride.
All right, Henry. Well,
I'll stay here.
You want to stay and listen?
Yes.
You could stay and listen, but we're gonna shift gears a little bit.
I still want to talk a little, though.
You do?
Yes.
Okay. Well, we're going to talk about merchandise and shopping at Disney. So this topic started from Randy, so why don't you tell us a little bit about why you're excited to talk about this
topic. I don't even know that I would probably just pigeonhole it to merchandise and shopping. The thought was just, it just came to my mind, like, we have a lot of really cool Disney stuff, right? Like, collections, right? Maybe if I were to title the episode, it'd be like Disney Collections. Most people, obviously, their collection starts in the stores. So they're gonna buy things and they're gonna collect it that way. People that know me know that I've got a pretty big collection of shirts. So many shirts, in fact, I don't even know how many there are anymore. But I got a big collection of shirts. But that's really what I wanted to talk about. Like, what are some of the coolest things that each of us have or have collected that are kind of Disney themed? If you come to our house, you'll see all sorts of stuff.
You know, it's funny that you talk about collections, because that was when I was making a list of just kind of shopping and merchandise and things. That was what I started. I just listed off Minnie Mouse. So people have like their thing. They like Stitch, or they like the Haunted Mansion stuff, or some people really like Jack Skellington, or what other things do people seem to obsess over? Everyone's kind of got like their thing, but mine is Minnie Mouse. I'm pretty loyal to the red, black and white Minnie Mouse stuff. I'm not huge on the pink stuff when they have that kind of stuff out.
What about classic Minnie Mouse, like original Minnie Mouse?
It's not my favorite.
With the flower in her hat.
No, that's not. I don't like the blue dress one either. I mean, it's not I don't like it, but when I want to buy stuff, my eye gets caught with the red and white and black.
Yeah.
And polka dots.
Well, I mean, you know, those colors, they're iconic, right? I mean, you can spot Mickey for the same reason, right? Just, you know, you got black, red, white, and yellow, you know, that's, you know, that's Mickey Mouse. And so with Minnie, you get the black and the red and the white, and you got the polka dots, you know, and you know exactly what it is.
What about Donald?
Yeah, we like Donald stuff, don't we?
No, we like being angry.
Oh, you like grumpy Donald. All right, listen. We're gonna have to out you from the podcast if you keep yelling.
I wanted to yell, but I can't.
Well, so, people want to hear us talk. So,
you know, one of the things that kind of that I guess what really kicked this off in my mind is you've got a birthday, and you just got a new cool thing, I think, to add to your collection.
I did, and I was thinking, I don't know what it's called.
It's a magic band scanner.
Oh, okay. Well, I just didn't know the name of it. Like, I could describe it, but I'm like, what is it called? The magic band scanner. So when you go, you know, you scan your magic band to go into the park or to go into a lightning lane or whatever, you have to match up either your park ticket or your magic band to this silver ball thing, and it lights up with a Mickey sign. And that was what I got for my birthday. Which I love.
A replica. It's not a real one. It's not.
Yeah. You know,
the real ones are made of steel, and you know they're really cool. But this is a replica that I found a person who makes them. It's 3D printed, and it is so realistic looking to like what you see at the park. Like it's like it's on the pedestal, and the colors and the motions and the sounds are very much in that kind of replica theme. And I just thought that was so cool for people that love the park so much and talk about it so much. And, you know, Kayla's been more than I have to Disney World, right? So why shouldn't she have her own magic band scanner so she can scan whatever she wants? And what's so cool about this thing, like it actually works. Like you can scan your magic band and it will.
It detects it and it'll start.
It'll do its song and dance for you.
Yeah, and it does. It plays Happily Ever After, which is my favorite fireworks show that they retired. So I love it. And it was funny, as I was opening this gift, I was like, I have no idea what he got me. I don't even know what I want, but I hope it's something Disney. That's all I thought. But then I'm kind of like, what do I even need, you know, or don't have?
Yeah.
I'm sure there are lots of things, but I'm just happy that it was a Disney thing.
I mean, I think that's the thing, right? I remember growing up, my grandma, she collected chickens. She loved chickens. And if you went and visited her house, she had all these, this chicken stuff, right? There were statuettes and all sorts of things and pictures and everything. And everyone always got her chickens. And it got to a point all of a sudden, she finally said, stop getting me chicken stuff. Like, please, you know, get me something else, right? But I wondered at what point, you know, we will get that way maybe with Disney themed items because we have so many of them.
Yeah.
And so I mean, I wanted to talk about some of the coolest ones.
Well, and I feel like you have a collection of, you said t-shirts, but I feel like socks is something else that you have a lot. And ties. So apparel, I guess.
Yeah. You know, I was thinking the only thing I don't have are like Disney pants, but that's almost not true because I actually do have some Mickey swim shorts.
I think I got you Mickey sweatpants or pajama pants once.
Oh yeah, I have, and I have Mickey pajama pants. I've got socks. I've obviously got lots of t-shirts. I have button-up shirts. I've got Hawaiian shirts. I have ties, neckties, and certainly a lot of socks. There is a theme though that kind of goes with my apparel. They don't all fit this theme, but I prefer ones that are kind of themed towards attractions. Like I like to get shirts that represent some of the great attractions that I love, right? So for instance, I've got a lot of Space Mountain shirts because that's my favorite ride, okay?
And Henry's, right, Henry?
And Henry's, right? He couldn't tell. But I got a lot of Space Mountain shirts. But, you know, like I've got Pirates of the Caribbean shirts. I've got Haunted Mansion shirts. I've got Star Wars shirts, right? But my Star Wars shirts, like, aren't generic ones. Like, I have Rise of the Resistance ones, and I have things that are themed to Galaxy's Edge. So I love to collect that because, you know, a lot of the ones that I get are shirts that you'll only see for a limited time because they're seasonal in the parks. And then they'll phase them out or they'll sell them out and then they'll make something different, right? And so to me, it literally is kind of like a collection.
Well, I'll just say a few other collections that we have at our house. We definitely have a collection of Stitch items. That is a favorite. I know Jack, our second son, Jack, loves Stitch. So we have a lot of Stitch items. And then I was going to mention Colin. He pretty much has any transportation, Disney transportation toy out there. I mean, we even have the parking lot tram. Like, of course, we had a monorail. That one was super cool. I mean, we still have it. We did get him something Disney Skyliner. That one's the newest, but I mean, the train. Oh, we have the train that goes around our Christmas tree.
We do have the Christmas train.
But I also, I'm pretty sure I don't sell this anymore, but I used to have a Mickey jacket that had the ears on the top, and it looked exactly like it, but now it doesn't fit me anymore, so I just keep it in my closet.
Yeah. I wrote that on my list because that's one of my favorite souvenirs. It's a hoodie, and the ears are on the hoodie part, and it was adorable. And that was like, I remember you bought it on Main Street.
Yep.
And it was like probably like $45 or something stupid, but it was so worth every penny. It was so cute.
Yep. I do remember that. Got it at the Emporium. I want to go back to the monorail for just a second too, though. We even have a doormat. We have a monorail doormat at our house. And what's the message on it?
Please
stand clear of the doors.
Clear of the doors.
Where is that?
You know, on our back porch, we have a doormat that says, please stand clear of the door. And then it also says it in Spanish.
And it says it in Spanish, too, just like the message says. So that's really cool. You know, one of my favorite things that I have, I get to look at it every day, but I have a collection of Run Disney medals for Disney races.
Yes. We've only done one and the parks.
Yeah. But somehow I have six. So there was a lot of virtual races last year. And so we've run, let's see, Yeah, I have run personally 5 virtual races. I think you've run the same amount that I have, right? Because we registered for all the same ones.
Yes, yes. I very hesitantly signed up to do that Lion King one last summer because I don't like to run in the heat like you do.
Yeah.
I don't even know if you like to run it, but you are willing to do it. But I did
it. It was awesome. I got my medals. They hang on my wall in my office, and right above them are my bibs for all the races. But that's a really cool one. But we have some cool, Disney-themed housewares, right? So something that I picked up on my most recent trip, actually, is this little pillow. It's almost like a neck pillow, but that's just because of the way it's shaped. But it's shaped like Mickey's head with his ears. It is super, super soft. It sits on the couch in my office here.
It's like the black. It's like the black Mickey ears that people wear. Yeah,
that's right. It's like the ears, the hat ears that people get their names stitched onto, right? And so, but it's a pillow, and I just love that kind of stuff. I know that every time we go to the parks, like one of the places that I always like to stop into is the Christmas shop, right?
The shoppy.
Christmas shoppy with an E, because I love Christmas so much, and I go sometimes a little crazy when I get the Christmas decorations going, but I love seeing what they have, right? And we have a huge collection of Disney Christmas stuff.
Well, we gotta go back to the Mickey ears. Come here, Henry. It's tricky to get 8-year-olds and microphones, all those things. Yes. But we love having you here. Okay, yes. So do you have any Mickey ears?
Yes, I have 2 pairs. I have one that you put like the rubber band around your chin, and then I also have the jacket that has the Mickey ears on the top of it.
Oh, yeah, the hoodie. But yeah, he has the black Mickey ears, kind of like your pillow, but the actual Mickey ears hat. And they'll stitch his name on the back.
Yeah.
And it makes me so happy. I'll be sad if that doesn't fit you one day. I'm sure it won't, but right now it still fits.
And one of the things that was cool, so kind of related to that, we've talked about the orchestra trip I got to chaperone back in February of this year, but all of the kids, the orchestra kids, they got some special ears, right? So unique to people that were performing in the workshop, and they're just like the typical black ones that you would buy in the shops, but
wait,
they were
Will
special.
Has this?
Will has a pair of
Where
these ears.
Where is it?
I don't know.
I don't know if I ever saw it.
He does have a pair of these ears. And so we talked about it. I told the kids, I'm like, hey, you can go and get your name stitched on there. But I also cautioned them that sometimes the name gets screwed up and there wasn't a replacement for these. So if you do it, you might be stuck with something. I don't know if he got his name put on it or not, but that's a cool kind of thing to have.
Yeah. Yeah.
I remember having ears as a kid. I totally remember having them. I don't have them anymore, right? I wish I did from Disneyland growing up. But that's about as iconic as you get from the theme parks as a little child, is you get your own pair of ears.
I would also like to say that when I was getting my ears, they messed up about at least 10 to 11 times.
Yeah. And it was late at night, and we were trying to have them put his name on there, and oh, it was so late, and they kept misspelling it. Luckily, he had ones that they could go and pull another one off the shelf and fix it, but...
Yeah.
Okay, so I have to say, I didn't have a lot of souvenirs or any, things as a kid, but I did get, I've talked about this before, when I was 6 or 7, the first time I went as a kid, I remember I got the lollipop, with all the different colors, cherry flavored, but it was the rainbow lollipop. And then the other thing I remember getting was Minnie Mouse ears.
Mm.
So this is back in the day when they were made out of hard plastic. And girls, you'll remember this, when the headband part had like the claws in it, and those claws were in there to kind of help it stick on your head and not fall off, but it just hurt.
I still remember those.
Yep, they're like I've seen them. At Nana's house. Yeah, so that was one of the very few souvenirs I got. And so later, my mom, she actually sewed me a Minnie Mouse costume, and I wore my ears and had my Minnie Mouse costume.
See, it made it worth it.
It did.
All that pain was worth it. You got a costume.
having your hair being in pain, losing it someday.
You guys, you don't even know
it's
worth it. The pains that women go through, the cost of beauty, I guess. But no, it was I just to me, part of why I love buying things at Disney, and it doesn't make sense budget wise or money wise, because it is pricey and it's not necessarily the best quality. Some stuff is better quality than others, but I'm just in such a happy place and a happy time, and I just want to like bottle that up and take it home. And so I literally do buy it and take it home. And when I, you know, months later, when I'm putting on that shirt I bought, I had like this rush of joy, you know, thinking about the park. Yeah.
Yeah. She has like multiple mini years. I've seen so much. Yeah. I've seen about like 4 pairs before.
Yep.
I think that's all I remember. 4 pairs of mini years. I've seen her buy most of them, but not all of them I've seen her buy. I've only seen her buy like 2 of them.
Yeah.
And at all of the Main Street shops, I've seen so much different types of mini ears.
Yes.
And some of them are just, they went too crazy on them. I mean, they look good, but they put way too much detail into most of them.
Well, there are lots and lots of ears out there to buy. And I would say that my collection, I think I have either 3 or 4. Is very small compared to other people, but I love all my ears.
So I want to go back and talk about Christmas. Can we talk about Christmas?
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to cut you off from your Christmas.
No, that's okay. Yeah. I mean, we're just talking about our collections, right? But I think if we're going to talk about our collections, we should talk about Christmas, because if I were to guess, that's probably our single biggest themed collection, right? Like something for... We have a lot of Christmas stuff, right?
It's so cute. I love all of it. And of course, you know me, I like the mini, the red, black, and white. Not necessarily black for Christmas, but there are so many cool red things to buy at Christmas. I just think of like that white blanket. Well, I mean, I guess that's not red, but that white blanket that you got me of Minnie and Mickey ice skating.
Yep. That's holding hands.
It's so soft. I'm used it. I also have, when I was at Disney World with my mom and my brother Colin, so we went to a shop and they only had like 1 or 2 pairs, like they only had 2 different types of these type of pajamas, like the ones you zip up, you put
with
on your legs, and
the
they
footed
still
ones,
zip up,
yeah, footed,
and then you zip it up.
Yeah.
And they have like these little things like
Christmas Mickey. Yeah.
Yeah, I have that, but it got a hole in it, so I only use it to go sleeping. One time at Disney World when we bought that, where it's still there. So I wear that to Disney World.
You're wearing your pajamas.
Yes.
You're wearing your pajamas at the park.
It was so hot. I was blazing hot.
That was a weird time when it was really hot and cold all in the same day. But yeah, I mean, if some people have the swagger that you can pull off PJs at Disney World.
I've seen people do it.
Yeah. But I do love our Christmas collection of, we have that Mickey mug. You got this for me, I think. The Mickey mug, yep. And his head is made out of cool.
His
like,
head is the cool whip, basically,
the cool
or the
whip
cream.
Yeah, the whipped cream.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good one.
So
what
we
other
have,
Christmas
we have a fair like? Amount of china, right? I mean, I don't want to call it china. It's just, but you know what I'm talking about. Plates, yeah. Mugs, glasses, dishes. There's a lot of that. And some is glass, some is plastic, but Christmas themed. We have table runners, right? So that,
that.
It kind of decorates the tables and fits in those sorts of themes. I mean, it's amazing. We have indoor stuff. We have outdoor stuff. There's a,
like,
when you come to our home, there is a fair amount of Disney to be seen from the street as you're driving by, right? I have projection spotlights that do some kind of cool things in some areas. We've got that really, really cool, like kind of twinkling topiary that sits by the door. And there's a huge Mickey headed wreath that's above our door. It's my favorite times. Like I said, I always like to shop at the Christmas shoppy because it's my favorite time of year. They're my favorite kinds of decorations. I just love being able to put them all up there.
Absolutely. Yeah. I forget half of it. So now I feel like, you know, you've talked about Christmas in July here.
Let's put it up tomorrow.
We could. What did you want to say, buddy?
So yeah, on Christmas we have, so when you come to our, if it was during Christmas and someone were to walk up our front door, there's this like little like pot, but there's just metal and a stick in it, and there's light. I'm pretty sure there's like glitter on. It's like a giant Mickey head that you put in the front, in our front door. I'm pretty sure it lights up.
It is. That's the topiary. Oh, but we also have another big thing too, and that's a Mickey street lamp. Christmas street lamp,
oh, yeah.
Right?
Oh yeah. We keep that indoors, otherwise it would get ruined outdoors.
But you know, it's kind of cool. There's certain places that have exclusive kind of selling arrangements with different types of vendors, right? And so Disney had an exclusive with Lowe's for a long time. Where Lowe's was the only place I think you could really find certain types of Disney-themed Christmas decorations. And so I would love to just get out there to Lowe's. You have to go early, and like it seems September. Like every year you got to go earlier and earlier because, yeah, come September now, if you don't get your Christmas stuff, like by October, it's gone.
Yeah.
Forget about Halloween. I don't even know what's going to happen with that. But it's crazy how early they start now. But I will say the last couple of years, that selection's been very disappointing. I don't know if this is COVID supply chain related or what, but I've bought a lot of things from Lowe's over the years at Christmas time that's Disney themed, and of course there is a cost with that because
the Disney
name on it alone, you know, increases the price, you know, probably three times what you would pay for something that wasn't, you know, Disney themed.
Well, I will say that one thing I do like about shopping at Disney itself is that we have the Disney Vacation Club discount. And so it makes it when you're shopping, you're like, okay, well, I'm going to get 20% off or 15% off or whatever. Is it usually 15 or 20?
It's usually 20. Sometimes 20. When they're doing special things, they've done 30.
But
it's usually 20 off merchandise. Now, it doesn't count for everything. And you do get a discount with your annual pass. If you're an annual pass holder,
oh, that's true.
There's usually one there too, but the DVC discount traditionally has kind of been the supreme one.
Well, how about we close it out with a couple of our like absolute favorite items we have. I have like two or three I want to list off.
All right. Well, you better start.
Okay. So at our old house when, so we used to have this giant Mickey fountain, but during Hurricane Harvey, it got ruined. So now we don't have it anymore, and I wish we had it. But when we moved into this house, it came with a fountain, and we fixed it, and it works.
But it's
now.
Not a Mickey fountain at our new house.
Yes,
that was a good item. I forgot about that. That made
I
me
like that fountain.
Lowe's.
Yeah, I did buy it at Lowe's. That's right. Yeah.
Okay, so a couple of my favorite items. This one I got at Epcot once at the D Technology Store. Is that what it's called? I don't know. But like they sell cell phone cases and D Tech maybe. Anyway, it's at the front of the park. But this was a Minnie Mouse cell phone carrying bag. It just has enough room for a cell phone. So it's not super practical if you want to carry like anything else, but it is so cute. It's of course got the red with the white polka dots. And then at the top, it has mini ears that poke out from the top with her bow. And it's just one of my favorite items.
I remember you getting that. And I actually thought, wow, I wouldn't carry something like that around, but I'm not embarrassed to go around with someone who carries something like that around. It was kind of cool.
That's funny.
So I have two favorites here, right? That I'll list. So I don't know which one reigns supreme, but there is one that I wear almost every single day, and it is a pair of Crocs.
I have these
incredibly comfortable Crocs. They're canvas. And if you go to the Croc store, they sell just normal Crocs that look just like this. But the difference is my Crocs, have Mickey on them. And yes, he's just kind of discreet and up in the corner, right? It's just a little silhouette. But I tell you, I've had so many people see my shoes and they're like, oh yeah, I got Crocs like that. And then they do a double take and they see Mickey and they're like, oh, that's actually pretty cool. So that's one of my favorites. They are so worn out and they're kind of grungy and dirty looking. Like, I would love to replace them, but the last couple of times I've been, I haven't seen them for sale. So I don't know if that's just it, but it's one of my favorites.
Yeah. Do you want to give us your next one? You said you had two.
So this would be my next one, right? And then I'd probably be done. But I have on the wall in my office next to my computer, next to my desk, I have on my wall, it's actually a kind of a piece of artwork. And it's not anything special because lots of people have them. But when we became Disney Vacation Club members, we got a little thing and we got a magazine or something like that. And in the magazine, there was this picture of Mickey walking in the door and the rug on the floor says, "Welcome home."
Aww.
And I just, you know, I keep it on my wall because Disney is a home for us, right? Like, yeah, I guess we kind of, you know, quote unquote, own property as Disney Vacation Club members, right? So it is home, right? But it is home because we go there and it's a place that, you know, we are together and we feel together and we get to do things that, you know, we love doing together. And so it's a home for us. And I like to be reminded of that as often as I can.
Well, and that's one reason why I love having Henry on tonight, because it's so fun to hear his perspective and his stories and the memories that he's got from all of our Disney stuff and memories and activities. Okay, so give us one more of your favorite. Do you have a favorite item, or do you just have a story to finish us up?
I have two favorite items, and one of them has a story in it.
All right, let's hear it.
So, one of my favorite items, I was at Rock and Roller Coaster when we finished the ride. I saw this shirt that said Rock and Roller Coaster, and I'm pretty sure I don't sell this anymore, but on the back was Mickey. He had this electric guitar, and he was, like, rock and rolling with it.
Yeah.
And it also had the, on the front of the shirt, it had the like track, but it was like a road and it had all the like signs and stuff. It was like the track, but instead it was a road actually. And
that was an awesome t-shirt.
I remember wearing that. I found it in my closet about a month ago and I tried to wear it, but you could barely, when I lifted up my hands,
it showed your belly button.
Yes. That shirt barely fit. That shirt would barely fit me. And I'm pretty sure I don't sell it anymore, but I wish they still sell it. I'm pretty sure I might, but I don't know if they do.
Maybe when your parents go next time, they can check and see if there's one your size.
Yes, you better, please. So this is, this is one of my favorite items I have on the list. So probably this is very memorable. But so I have the Mickey ears that are on my wall. I'm pretty sure they don't make the exact Mickey ears now. And I have a stitching. It says Henry on the back.
I love that.
And part of the rubber band is almost teared.
Yeah.
But luckily it's not teared fully. So I sometimes wear that and just, I'd like to use it as a memory.
Aww. Well, I'll give you a couple of my favorites here to close us out. So one Christmas, I got a glass rose that was like from Beast Castle. That one is amazing. That's
blown glass from the Arribas brothers.
I know. And I love that it's two of my favorite things, Main Street and Beauty and the Beast. Those are two of my very favorites.
Also, I want to tell you who got that from. So during Christmas, we went in separate times. So me, Mom, and Colin went one time. And then after, like, a week after, then the other three went. Dad, Will, and Jack went. And while they were there, I'm pretty sure they found this rose, like, in Main Street. And they bought this for Mom as a Christmas gift.
Yeah, it was a big Christmas gift, which is tricky. I'm even impressed that it made the flight and it didn't break like that. I don't even know if I could walk out of the store without it breaking. So good job, Arribas Brothers.
It had its own suitcase to be carried on in.
Oh, that's how loved I am. Well, that's one of my very favorites. A couple others. We have a one time I went to Norway, Epcot, Norway, and there was an artist there that had a bunch of his own artwork, and he was there signing things and selling his artwork. And in our bedroom, which I'm a little embarrassed, but I don't care. Also, I have this this painting of Elsa. You can see that she's just made, you know, she's over at the North Mountain and she's just made her ice castle. And Olaf is there, but she just has her arms open in a way that she just looks like, I don't know, she just looks free.
I used to love that movie when I was like 4, but then when I was 5, I'm like, I realized how bad that movie was.
No.
After I've seen so much other movies, I realized...
We love that movie. It's okay.
I know it was a decent. The second movie was a lot better than the first one, I'd say.
All right. That was a really neat experience to have the artist there and to buy that artwork. So, I don't know. It's just the stories that go along with the stuff. You know, maybe a few generations from now, people are, you know, our kids are going to be like, this is cool, but it doesn't mean anything, but it means something to us because there's a story that goes with it. But unless right. Maybe they'll listen to this podcast one day and go, well, great grandma Mackay, we got to make sure and keep it because whatever.
Yeah.
Because of her story.
Right.
It's going to be so funny when you see your kids, you're going to be like, my grandma. How
well, just Disney. This was a cool one. This was a lot of fun. It was awesome to have our extended stay guest on. Thanks, Henry, for joining us.
Well, we want to give a special shout out to our technical producer that had to figure out how to make us. Hopefully you guys could hear us with our extra voice today. But we hope you guys just love shopping at Disney and finding those collections and those things that just spark joy for you. Say thanks.
Thanks for listening to the end of this podcast. I don't know how to. Oh.
You don't know how to end things. We'll let Dad have the last word here.
He's my dad.
Thanks for tuning in, y'all. Drop us a note. Check us out on Instagram. Let us know what some of your favorite collections are. And we'll catch you next time.
Bye.